Disability Pride was born because my daughter, one of my adopted disabled children, had an incident of disability discrimination last year, and I wrote about it and the Facebook post went viral. And as part of one of my posts, I said, "Disability Pride, anyone?" And everybody said, "Yes, yeah, that's a fantastic idea." So that's how it happened. And I then started Googling and found that we were the first in the country, and that lots of disability prides happen in America. And we're linking in with Disability Pride New York and Italia. The whole disabled community has got involved. We have a committee made up of disabled people, and there will be lots of acts and performances, music, arts, all with people who identify as having a disability. A maze will be coming along. I think the Undateables are coming. Lots of stores giving out information to people about disabilities, mainly charities. And it'll just be a fun day, and it's not going to rain.
Yeah, so we're funded by People's Health Trust through the Health Lottery. So it's about disabled people and carers in Brighton being able to run projects for themselves and say what needs to change and what needs to happen. So that's how I met Jenny, and we funded an open meeting for all the disabled people in Brighton Hove and carers to say what they wanted out of Pride. So that was really interesting. Hopefully it gave me some ideas. Yeah.
The LGBT Community Safety Forum are providing their initiative Accessibility Matters, which was born basically for the same reasons as Disability Pride, where so many people that live in the city or visit the city with disabilities, in particular hidden disabilities, they find it difficult to access elements of events and stuff, and it can all be based on whether or not people perceive them to not have a disability, or if they need a form of medication that they don't want their friends to know about the medication. So there's lots of different reasons why. So we're going to be on site with our Accessibility Matters tent. We'll have British Sign Language interpreters so that people can go off and do a takeaway so they can be involved with other stalls, an information base, a charge-up station for mobility equipment, and we're just there really to do an overall support.
I'm really looking forward to lots of people coming together across different impairments with different needs to realise we've got much more in common than we do separately, and just to feel more connected and more welcome in the city.
There are so many visible disabilities, but also so many invisible disabilities, and that's what we want to focus on as well, because I was contacted by hundreds of people afterwards to say they'd had very similar experiences, people who were blind, people who have disabilities that aren't as visible as other disabilities, and so I really wanted to focus on that.